place?
Well, it was called All Our Yesterdays, and it was the story of, I'm sure each person would have the idea that it was the story about them, but it was the story, I think, ultimately of it was a love story of a young woman who was caught in a time tunnel, and McCoy, who was dead to the world. See, that was the only way, I guess, that Leonard could kind of come on to me, was to not have McCoy conscious.
You want to stay here. As a matter of fact, you're highly motivated to stay in this forsaken waste.
Prospect appeared quite attractive to you a moment ago.
We were the three people in this cave. I found them in this time tunnel and was all in this kind of fake fur Eskimo kind of thing, covered, looking like a Bigfoot. And as I came into the cave with them, I of course dropped this, and this creature emerged, very self-consciously, I must say. Oh my God, I was so embarrassed about what I had to wear, because I've always been embarrassed about being as tall as I am and having the body that I have. So having breasts out to here that were quite fake, and you know, I've always been a little bit conscious of my legs because, well, my father taught me how to whistle because he said with my legs I'd never be able to get a cab in New York. So I was there feeling as naked as a jaybird. And the guys were great, they were so sweet to me. And it was one of the first shows I actually did. But I mean, look, I mean, let's face it, before he met me, Spock was a vegetarian. You know what I'm saying?
What are you called?
I'm called Spock.
Even your name is strange.
In that cave, and that beautiful light, and that amber light, and the two of us developed this kind of love affair.
You are beautiful.
I taught him how to eat meat. I mean, I don't know how else to say it. It was a very sexual, he fell in love. You know, I mean, he was very taken with this redheaded kid from Connecticut. And, we had a wonderful time doing it. Of course, I had no idea how epic it was, but I had a feeling that it was very special, that I was in something that was very special. And to me, it is. I mean, I watched all of them. I mean, I just adored the show.
Do you know what it's like to be alone? Really alone?
Yes. I know what it is like.
I felt that Sarah Beth was,
I believe you do,
was really lonely. I felt that that there was a sense of isolation, and it was certainly very clear in the script. It was a very well-written script. That she had never seen people, certainly not seen them for a long time, that she was kind of awakening. That Leonard, in a sense, that Spock, in a sense, the Vulcan, actually awakened her.
What is wrong with me? I tell you, you're beautiful. But you are beautiful.
And she responded very sensuously. It was a nice opportunity for me because up until then I played frigid school teachers and plain passive sisters whose good-looking sister always got the guy in the end. So it was kind of nice to get turned on a little in television. There was a kind of magic. There was a mystical kind of quality to it.
I am substantial. You are not imagining this.
You could tell that the rocks were fake. You knew that those things that glommed on you were plastic, you know. That, I mean, but it didn't matter. You were so connected with those people. And I was a total fan. So I sensed that this was very special, particularly because Spock had never really been with anybody except maybe one other redhead. I guess he kind of liked redheads. But I think I was like one of the first women that he ever kind of opened his heart to, which was a real new thing for him.
Please pay no attention. I'm not myself.
along that line about how astonishing it is to be a part of a kind of cult thing, which is always amazing to me. I'm always amazed at how those things occur. I mean, I didn't even know that there was a book out called Son of Zarabeth.
I've always loved books about such possibilities.
You know, it was the least painful birth I've ever been through.